Hey, another day here at Handy Randy. All right, so in our previous video, you've seen us refinishing the cabinets. Okay, now we're doing it the white color. Now we're gonna do the bottom gray. I already deglossed it. Now we gotta just take off the doors as before. Label your doors with the numbers and even your drawers. Makes the job easier. So I already got most of the drawers out. This is what we're going to do. I'm going to show you because it's a little bit different when you're doing the drawers. You got to mask it up. You want to mask up the drawers when you do it. Because you don't want any paint getting along the edge. Okay, so I'm going to show you. I'm going to show you how to mask up along the edge. So what you do? You push tape, because you want to paint the backside as well. That way, this only the inside is still whatever color that your old cabinets or old drawers, so it can be look like it came from the factory like that, like it came from the manufacturer. So you want to tape up around the track, all behind you here. I'm just going to paint all back here. I'm going to paint this as well. Okay, so now you want to take off your cabinet doors. Put your screws on top so you can keep up with keep the hinges and stuff separate. Need another cup for the hinges. Okay, we got all the drawers out, all the cabinets off, doors off. So now it's gonna be time to mask it up. So let's get busy. Start from here. Gonna make sure there's no dust, anything on the floor, so you can get a good adhesion of the tape. Thank you. make sure you press it real firm. You don't want it to bleed through. Press firm along the edges. Make sure you got a good seal. Get your scraper. Just go right along the edge. Then that's how you tear off your end. Make sure you have a nice good end. Countertop is showing, so. You want to tape underneath as well, because you don't want to get any paint on the countertop. See a piece that's not sticking good, tear it off. Make sure you got a good adhesion, because it will bleed through that piece. You don't want that. Right along the edge, along the wall, and the trim. You want to do some good prep work. Prepping this most of the job. Make sure you have good prep. Right. So that's taped up. Then we're going to work our way around. Okay, you guys suggest of it, so we'll be back. All right, so we got everything masked off. I'm gonna take everything up. So now we're gonna start with our gray. So stir it up back and forth. Get your brush. On the edges first. You don't want to get too much because you don't want it to drip. Okay. Now you want to dip your roller, get it in nice and wet. You're going to be rolling this out because you can see it better on this side. You don't want to see the paint lines from the brush. You're going to roll this one out. It's going to look a little see-through, but it's your first coat, so don't worry about that. We have the cardboard here for splatter. You can use a drop cloth as well. I just like the cardboard. Easier just to move around. Got my mechanics stool. So I can just roll. down. Top to bottom so you can have nice even strokes. First coat. All right. Get the gist of it.
So we'll be back.
All right. So I just want to show you guys how to do the inside as well. So you want to get your brush, since we're around here where the cabinet doors are at. Because you still want to have it like this. See how that side is? Where the inside is done along the edge. So that's what we're going to show you here. I'm gonna get it along the edge. You have these tracks here, so you just wanna get your corners with the brush, and then just get tap it right there around the tracks. And get your corners with your brush. If you're not comfortable, you can take the drawers out and take up where the track is at. But all you gotta do is just really let the bristles go right there. Right by the track. Save you a little time.
Just a little bit.
And get your corners with the brush. That's where you wanna get the bottom trim. Along here at the bottom of the cabinets, because the rest of it you can roll out. Don't pick too much because you don't want it to drip. So you have this piece here, this doesn't come out. So you want to go around it with a brush. Start at the top. Work your way around it. Brush. Get your sides. Cabinet, that's why you keep the main countertop. That's why you keep your little wet rag. Okay. So I got all around it. Now you want to do your around the front and the edge. Along your edge. You want to make sure the brush is a little wet for this part. Just to make sure you got good coverage. Give it a nice even stroke. strokes. So now since we have our corners done, now we can roll it up. Just roll out the edge, the inside edge. Inside. Also, you're gonna need a brush for your corners. Get your corners to the top. Top, roll out your top. Roll out the inside edge. This piece where the cabinet connect. You might want to go back and forth, get some paint in that crack. It separates it, so go back and forth just a little bit. And then give it one long, even stroke. So it could be even. And also when you're doing these cabinets, you want to go with the grain. This one, I got to tell you guys that. Sometimes you might even get a little hair or something in there, so you may have to just pick it out because you don't want that in your finished product. So how that looks. That's how it looks. Okay, so we already did our edging around the bottom. So what we're gonna do now? I'm going to just go ahead and roll that out as well. Sometimes it's where the cabinets meet, so it might have to just go up and down in that area, but then just go across where the cabinets meet. You see right here, that's what I'm talking about right there. So we're gonna just go up and down right there, and then you work your way across again. Yeah. Okay, so we had the cabinet doors here. You want to use the brush to go around the inside trim, but we're gonna do another one because I already started this one. Okay, so we're going on the outside. Remember, it's always the first coat, so it's not gonna be so solid. Relax. No worries. Okay, so you want to start off just doing the inside corners. Corner's there, good. That corner's right there. Corner's good. And then, roll out your middle, start from the middle, work each end. Make sure you got your edges good. Make sure you don't have no drips or anything. See no lines from the rotor. Now you might gotta roll it out, let the roller drive a little bit, then go over it to make sure you don't have any lines. What happens is when the roller's too wet, it'll leave a line. This is three coats. This is dry. So once it's finished with the finished drying, we'll put the clear coat on. Looking nice and solid. Here's the doors, three coats. Still a little wet. Just looking nice and solid. Drawers looking good. Okay. We have hit four coats of base coat on. Now it's time for the top coat. It's the same thing. Like you're putting on your base, you don't want to get too much on it. Corners first. Corners real good. You definitely want to make sure this doesn't have any drips or runs, because once it dries, if it dries with the drip, it'll dry like a yellowish color. So you want to try to have it. Not too runny. brush. And I want to make sure it's not running the tricks. This is the final coat, so make sure this is perfect. You want to give it some nice long strokes. Corners. You see any part that's white? That's the clear coat, so you want to make sure it's not extra. Yeah? So go along your sides. Just make sure it's not that extra there. It dries pretty quick, so. I want to make sure you have even coverage. As you may see it once it's dry. Middle, work your way to each end. Get a nice coverage. Sides of the door. You see, I'm walking around to both ends to make sure I don't see any drips or anything. That's why I'm rotating from each side. Go back and forth, make sure you have good coat. Definitely want to check them corners. Make sure you don't have any white in the corner. Because once again, once it's dry, it's going to leave a yellowish film. back and forth, make sure it's covered good. Have good coverage. You need to move it, you can grab it. It's gonna come out beautiful. Again, take your time. No big rush. Okay, finished product. Gray bottom, white top. New door. Kitchen complete.